Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we are starting a Clapeyron's three moment theorem. In that we are starting problem number one. In problem number one, we will see problem on continuous beam on bolt and hinge. Our first one will be nothing but bolt and hinge. So let's see in details. Now see, this is a problem friends. A problem is given over here is problem on bolt and hinge. First of all, why we are using this continuous beam by using three moment theorems? Because it's all are the indeterminate structure. To indeterminate structure, we have to apply the formulas name as Clapeyron's three moment theorem to find the supports reactions. Okay, so let's see the problem on bolt and fix. Now this is a question number one given to us. Analyze the continuous beam by using three moment theorem. The name indicates three moment theorem. You have to remember three things. Three moment theorem. What three things we have to remember? I will explain after that. Okay. Three moment theorem. So this is a question given to us. See, this is a question given to us. A, B, C, D. That is it. E, then F, and then G. Okay. Now let's start with the solution. What are our steps will be? Our first step will be draw the free bending moment diagram. First of all, we have to draw the free bending moment diagram. So let's start the solution in next page. First step will be free bending moment. Okay. Now we have to find the free bending moment and considering each span simply. Now see, since this is a problem number one, explain each and everything in details. So it will get lengthy. So please listen. First step will be free bending moment. We have to find the free bending moment. To find the free bending moment, what we have to do? Considering each span simply supported. We have to consider each span will be as a simply supported beam. Okay. So this is a question given to us. Now first of all, first span will be AB. We have to consider AB span will be simply supported. And see, the formula, this UDA point load is there at certain distance. This is 2 meter, means this one will be 4 meter. Since here our A is equal to 2 meter and B is equal to 4 meter. Here also see, A is equal to 2 meter and B is equal to 3 meter, since it is a eccentricity of load. Okay. So let's start the first one. As I'm explaining previous one, that if point load is there at certain A and B distance, the formula of free bending moment will be WAB by L. So how we have to write? We have to write like this. See, we have to write like this. For span AB, bending moment at E is equal to WAB by L is equal to, your W will be, see, your W will be 80, A will be 2, B will be 4, and L will be 6. So 80 into 2 into 4 upon 6 equal to 106.67 kilonewton meter. Okay, now let's try take the second beam. For span BC, bending moment at F is equal to, since second beam will be UD, overall UDL, so formula will be WL square upon 8. So WL square upon 8, your W will be 20, L will be 5 and 8. The answer will be 62.5 kilonewton meter. The third part will be for span C and D, bending moment at G is equal to WAB by L. W will be 60, A will be 2 and B will be 3 upon 5 is equal to 72 kilonewton meter. Here we have done with this problem, here we have done with this step 1. See, first beam will be WAB by L, WL square by 8, WAB by L. Put all the values, see, bending moment at E, F and G. So you can write like this, for span AB, for span BC, then for span CD. After that, Let's move on to next step. Next step will be, now we have to draw the free bending moment diagram of this. We have written this one and this one. You have to draw the bending moment diagram. So let's start with the next step will be free bending moment diagram. Now we have calculated the free bending moment. Now we have to draw the diagram. So how will you draw the diagram? So as you all know, this bending moment diagram will be look like this. Since it is a point load, so it will get triangle. This is UDL, means this will curve, parabolic curve, and this is it's a point load and triangle. Okay, this is a basic thing, you should know these things. Now we have write all the values: 106.67, 62.5, and then 72. A, B, C, and D. This is 6 meter, this is 5 meter, and this is also 5 meter. Now after that, what we have to do, we have to find the area of all these three parts. We have to find all the area of all these three parts. So just we have to cut it into three parts like this. Now see, how will you find? See, now area of triangle will be, area of triangle will be half into base into height. So here our base will be 6 and height will be 106.67. Here its value will come 320.01. This is our value. Okay, after that, what we have to find, we have to find this distance, at what distance our CG will be act in this triangle. So how will you find? See, XL means from left side how much CG is there, and XR will be from right side how much CG is there. XL formula will be A plus L upon 3. A will be, our A will be 2 plus 6 upon 3 is equal to 2.67 meter. B plus L upon 3, XR formula will be B plus L upon 3. B will be 4 plus 6 upon 3 is equal to 3.33 meter. Okay. This, what is the use of XL and XR? I will explain after that. Let's find out first. Here also area will be, see, area of parabola will be 2 by 3 B into H. 2 by 3 into B will be 5, H will be 62.5. The answer will come 208.33. Okay. Now XL will be 2.5, XR will be 2.5. Since it's a parabola, half will be this side, half will be at center, CG is there. It's not a similar triangle because it is 2 meter here and 4 meter. That's why its CG will be get different. Okay. Here also same as it is, area will be half into base into height, half into 5 into 72. Answer will get 180. XL formula will be A plus L upon 3. XR formula will be B plus L upon 3. 2 plus 5 upon 3 is equal to 2.33. 3 plus 5 upon 3 is equal to 2.67 meter. Okay friends, now we have done with the step 2 also. Now we have done with the, now we calculate the area of the free bending moment. Now we have done with this, all this, find the areas and XL and XR. Now what is XL and XR? Let's see, I will explain after that. Now let's move on to third step. Our third step will be, third step will be applying theorem of three moment or Clapeyron's theorem. Now we have to apply the three moment theorem. So third step will be apply three moment theorem. Okay, it's very interesting topic friends. Now see, as the name indicates, a three moment means anything we have to require is three. So for, we have to write over here for A, B and C. Now I'm explaining how will you write the formulas A, B and C. See, why you are taking like this? See, this is a question. As the name indicates, three moment. If we take A, B and C. Here we have find B. If we take B, C, D, here we have find at C. As a three moment, we have to always consider three part A, B, C, B, C, D. If we have one more member, then C, D, E. Okay. So what you have to do for A, B and C. So now let's take the general equations of three moment theorem will be, see, this is A. So here will come M, A, L1 plus 2MB L1 plus L2. Since this is a B, this also is B. Plus MC L2 plus 6A1 X1 upon L1 plus 6A2 X2 upon L2 is equal to 0. This is a general equation of three moment theorem, or you can say as formulas. Now friends, see, if we are when we are taking A, B and C, see this diagram. Now we are considering A, B and C. So neglect this part. Always remember these things. A, B and C, as we are seeing A, B, C part. Now what you have to do is, now right, since at MA at this side there is no load, therefore MA will be 0. You can write over here 0 plus 2MB is there, because in 2MB we have got the value. L1 will be 6 and L2 will be 5, plus MC also had some value. So MC into L2 will be 5. Now always remember, if we are considering this and this part, the L1 will be this and L2 will be this. If we are considering B, C, D, L1 will be this part, L2 will be this part. No need to write L1, L2 and L3. It will get confused to you. Always remember, we are considering at a time three parts, A, B and C. AB will be L1 and BC will be L2. When we are considering B, C and D, at that time L1 will be this, L2 will be this. It's quite simple. Its formula would get never change. Always L1 and L2 is there. Okay. This has 5. Okay. After that, plus 6. Area of A1 will be this. Area of A1 will be 302. Now X1 is very important. Now see, when we are considering A, B, C, we have to take this distance as X. When we are considering extreme, we have to take the X value from the corner. See, from the here X value we want. From here we will, XL will be this 2.67. from here this value will be R. So please remember, if we are taking this beam, so we want this distance from here to here, from here to here. Okay, that's why I'm writing this will be XL and this will be SR of second part. So here we have to take 2.67, here we have to take this 2.5, and here we have to 2.67. so you have to write 2.67 upon 6 plus 6. Area 2 will be 208.33. Now X2 will be 2.5 upon L2 will be 5 is equal to 0. Okay friends, please remember, we want X distance from the extreme corner. If we are taking this part, we want this X and this X. Okay, if we are taking this part, we want this X and this X. Always take the X value will be extreme corner, either it is LX or LR. Okay, now see, here will be LX and here will be XR, because we are taking from here, this is from XR. Okay, this is from left side, this is from right side. Okay, now let's start with the solutions here. Now see, while solving this, you get will be 22MB plus 5MC is equal to minus 1479.42. It is equation number 1. Now for, we have done with A, B, C. Now for B, C and D. So write the formula. How will you write the formula? See, always see this and write the formula. See, MB L1 plus 2MC L1 plus L2 plus M DL2 plus 6A1 X1 upon L1 plus 6A2 X2 upon L2 is equal to 0. Okay, see, it's what, simple. See, MB will be, something is there, we have to find MB. So we will write directly MB will be 5 plus 2MC. MC is also, something is there, L1 will be 5 plus L2 will be also 5. Now see, when we are seeing BCD, our L1 will be BC and L2 will be CD. Please listen carefully, students. We have to remember these things in the exam. If we are taking BC, this is your L1. We are taking CD, this is your L2. Okay. Now see here, see L1 will be also 5 and L2 is also 5. Don't forget to write L1 will 6 and L2 will 3 and L3. I am not taking L3 to be considered in this chapter. I am always dealing with L1 and L2. Because in three moment theorem, we have to take only two part at a time. A, B and C or B, C or D. Okay. So please remember L1 and L2 or A1 or A2. That's why I am not right here also A1, A2 and A3. Because in exam, we can get have confused to A1, A2 and A3. That's why I always take L1 and L2. Okay. And write the formula to see this part. Now after that, plus MD will be 0 as it is a corner, plus 6. Now area 1 will be this. This is your area 1, 208.33. After that, x1 will be from here. This from here x means xr, xl will be 2.5. Now area 2 will be 180. And distance C. Now we have to take the distance from the this part, right hand side. So 2.67. L2 will also 5 is equal to 0. While solving this, you get 5 MB plus 20 MC is equal to minus 1201.71. Right as equation number 2. Now we have to take the calculator and in equation we have solved. Now solving 1 and 2 we get, now you can solve direct by the calculator, you get the value of MB will be minus 56.82 kilonewton meter and MC will be minus 45.88 kilonewton meter. This is our final moments. Okay, final moments, 56.82 kilonewton meter, 45.88 kilonewton meter. Okay, friends. Now, after that, we have done with this. What step will we have done? Here we have done step 3 also. We can apply the three moment theorems. After that, find the reaction at support, then draw the SFD and BMD. Now, let's see how you find the reaction at support. Fourth step will be find the reaction at support. Now see, after drawing this, what how will you draw? Like you have to draw like this. See, this RA, RB, RB, RC, RC, RD. Okay, take different parts and see. We are finding this moment. We have find anticlockwise. See, hugging. This is also hugging because all the answer will be minus 56.82. This is also hugging. This is also hugging. This is nothing but 45.88. Now after that, now you have to deal with clockwise moment and anticlockwise positive and clockwise positive and anticlockwise negative. It's quite simple. Let's see. Now see, for span AB we are calculating now, this one. So what you have to do, take moment at A equal to 0 clockwise positive. Now see what are the possibilities is there. This 80 into 2 plus, after that minus RB into 6, after the C, this is going in clockwise direction, 56.82. So you have to write plus 56.82 equal to 0. Here RB will be 36.14 kilonewton. Okay, after that summation FY equal to 0 upward positive. Now RA, you see you have what this value, 36.14 kilonewton. Okay, RA minus 80 plus 36.14 equal to 0. Here RA will be 43.86 kilonewton. Okay. It's very simple to find. Now see, when we are solving for span BC, take moment at A as it is. Now forget this part. You only remember only this point B. See, taking moment at A equal to 0 clockwise positive. Okay. Now see, first of all, this UDL 20 into 5 into 5 by 2 plus 20 into 5 into 5 by 2 plus, after that minus RC into this distance is 5. Now see, this is also at B, this is anti-clockwise, so minus 56.82, this is clockwise, so plus 45.88 equal to 0. While solving this, you get the RC value will be 47.812 kilonewton. Okay, so you have right over here 47.812. after that, summation Fy equal to 0, upward positive. Okay, upward positive. So RB minus 20 into 5 plus 47.812 is equal to 0. Here no need to write the couples because we are dealing with Fy and Fx. So here RB will be 52.188 kilonewton. 52.188 kilonewton. Okay, now for span C and D, taking moment at C equal, sorry, here we have put bending moment, same moment at B. Please remember, is moment at B, not A. You will get confused when we are right at A. We are taking bending moment over here at C. So what are the possibilities? 60 into 2 minus RD into 5, and now see, this is anti-clockwise, so minus 45.88 equal to 0. Here RD will come 14.83 kilonewton. After that, summation Fy equal to 0, upward positive. RD will be 114.83. RC minus 60 plus 14.83 equal to 0. Here RC will be 45.17 kilonewton. Okay friends, it's very simple. You have to first, what you have to do, we have to draw these different parts and apply the moments. We have find different span AB, then BC and CD. When we are taking at AB, always consider only AB part, no need to see at BC parts. Okay, now we have done this part. Now let's see what are the final reaction will come. Reaction at A, so you can write over here, reaction at A will be 43.86 kilonewton. Reaction at B will be, now see, when we are writing reaction at B, you have to add both of them. This will be 36.14 plus this 52.188 is equal to 88.33 kilonewton. This is your B. Now reaction at C will be, add both of them, 47.18 plus 45.17. 812 plus 45.17 equal to 92.98 kilonewton. Reaction at D will be 14.83 kilonewton. Now these are the final reaction at A, B, C and D. Now after that, what you have to do, we have to draw the shear force diagram or bending moment diagram. Now let's see how you draw the bending moment diagram. Fifth step will be, step fifth will be, draw bending moment diagram and shear force diagram. Okay, so first of all, we have to draw bending moment diagram. How will you draw the bending moment diagram? Or what you have to do, see, so first we have to draw the, see, first what you have to draw, first draw the diagram like this. We are finding all the reactions, that's why. We know this value 43.86, we know this value also 88.33, we know this value also 92.98, we know this value also 14.83. okay,
80 kilonewton and here will be 60 kilonewton. Okay, A, B, C and D.
Now you can extend this part. Then draw the SFD and BMD. Now how will you draw the SFD? By bending moment diagram, C. Okay, now here we have find a moment will be, we have find over here 856 something like 50 will come over, this 45 will come over here. This is nothing but 56.82, this is nothing but 45.88. Now you can draw like this. Okay, you know this value, you can write it over here. Now this is nothing but this is 6 meter, 5 meter, 5 meter, A, B, C and D. This is nothing but bending moment diagram. Now you have to draw the shear force diagram. To draw the shear force diagram, first you have to calculate the shear force diagram. Now see friends, we have here we have to find the shear force diagram. To find the shear force diagram, first you have to find. Now let's see, write it over here. Shear force calculation. Now we are finding shear force diagram. Sign conversion will be is positive. Now let's start. Now see how you are finding shear force. As you all know, we are taking just left and just right at all part A, B, C, D. You can write as E at F. Okay. Now see shear force A at left. What's value will come over here? Shear force A at left will be 0. Shear force A at right will be, now see you are taking section over here and we are seeing this side. While take the section, either you can see this side, either left side or right side. So it will be upward. From we are seeing left side upward will positive. So 43.86 kilonewton. To get better understand the shear force and bending moment diagram, you can see the previous videos of structural analysis 1, AFD and SFD of the frames. There I have explained clearly what is shear force and what is bending moment diagram and how to draw. Okay, I'm just writing fast because it's quite complicated sums will there. Okay, because too long sum is there now. In next sum, you will find out all the SFD and BMD by your own. Okay, now shear force, now E at left. Now see, we are taking section over here, E. E and we are seeing left side. So it will come 43.86 kilonewton only. Now shear force E at right. Now when we are jump to here, we are taking this side only, this will get plus and this will get minus. So 43.86, see downward will be minus in left side. So minus 80, it will come minus 36.14 kilonewton. After that, shear force B at left. Now see, we are taking B at left means section as we are seeing this side only. So same as it is comes 36.14 kilonewton. After that shear force B at right, we are taking, just we are taking right, no need to take what the UDL is come in the picture because we are seeing this side. So this 43 will plus, 80 will minus and 88.3 will be plus. So 43.86 minus 80 plus 88.33, it will get 52.19 kilonewton. Okay, now shear force B will be done, now C at left. Now see, now we are taking C at left, we are taking section over here. Now we not see this side, we will see this side because always ignores the UDLs because it will get quite complicated to you. So now we will see this side. In this side, downward will be positive and upward will be negative. Now this will be negative, this will be positive and this will be negative, which is 14.83 negative. 14.83 will be negative, minus 14.83 plus 60 minus 92.98, it will get minus 47.81 kilonewton. Now shear force C at right. Now we are taking right means here and we are seeing this side. So 14.83 minus plus 60, 14.83 minus plus 60 is equal to 45.7 kilonewton. After that shear force F at left means here, if we are seeing this set same as it is, 45 0.7 kilonewton. Now shear force F at right. Now we are taking section over here and we are seeing this side, already this will come. This is minus 14.83. Okay, now shear force D at left will be minus 14.83 kilonewton. Shear force D at right will be 0. Finally, we have done with the shear force calculation. Now draw the diagram over here. See, you have to extend this part also to draw the SFD. Okay, now draw the diagram. Now how will you draw the diagram? See, shear force A will be at left will be 0. After that 43.86 at A at right, 43.86, come over here. After that, same as it is, come over here. I'm just drawing, you will. Now this is a shear force diagram. Now write all the values. 43.86. This is nothing but shear force diagram. Now we will complete all the 5 steps of the Clapeyron's free moment theorem. Is this: draw the free bending moment diagram, calculate the area, then applying free moment, then find reaction, then draw SFD and BMD. Because it's a problem number 1, that's why I'm explaining in details. In problem number 10, we will do the fast, okay? I hope you understand these videos and share with your friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe the eKida channel. Thank you.